There's lots of stories of people surviving falls from incredible heights, including one of a woman surviving a fall from a whopping 33,000 feet after being sucked out of a plane. On January 26, 1972, flight attendant Vesna Vulovic fell an astonishing 33,300 feet from her airplane in the mountains of Czechoslovakia. Suffering from brain hemorrhage, several crushed vertebrae, and two broken legs, she was not expected to survive, but awoke from a coma 2 days later. But while events like that may be freak occurrences, what would actually happen if, say, you belly flopped from 100 feet high directly onto water? Well, first, water is soft and thus safer than the ground, right? Well, not quite. See, when you fall, your body begins accelerating, and the potential energy stored in your body is turned into kinetic energy. The longer a fall lasts, the more kinetic energy you generate, until hitting a peak maximum based off your mass and total acceleration. In short, the longer you fall and the bigger you are, the more kinetic energy you generate. But when you finally hit a surface and come to a stop, all that kinetic energy is then transferred to the impact site. Now, when you hit a liquid, all of these same physics are in play. But as a dynamic medium, water can actually move and be displaced, which is why you can generally survive falls from a greater elevation. But with enough speed, mass, and kinetic energy, even a liquid like water can behave very, very unexpectedly. At a height of 100 feet, the average person will reach a velocity of roughly 80 feet per second, or 54 miles per hour. As your body impacts the water, it transfers all its kinetic energy to the water, forcing water molecules to move away. But at such high speeds, the water molecules are forced to move too much too quickly and encounter massive resistance from every other water molecule it pushes against. This creates a reactionary force that pushes back against the object, forcing the water to move, in this case, your own body. The greater the surface area, the larger the amount of water that is forced to try to get out of your way in a shorter amount of time. So the greater the force exerted back on you. That means that from a height of 100 feet and an average speed reached of 54 miles per hour, a belly flop carries a strong chance of outright death. Though even if you don't die, you may wish you had. At these speeds, water can exert so much force on your body that it'll shatter bones and rupture organs, causing massive internal hemorrhaging. While trained cliff divers do routinely make jumps from these heights, they have learned how to properly enter the water and increase their rate of deceleration, thus reducing the amount of force returned. So while it may look like great fun, maybe it's best to always leave the cliff diving to the professionals. If you want to make Fuzzy and Nutz happy, click that like button and subscribe to their channel.